Assalamu alaikum. I welcome you all for class 8 subject science. So today we are going to start a new topic, that is chemical effects of electric current. So your elders might have cautioned you that you are against touching an electric appliances with wet hands. Means they will stop you by touching any electric things with your wet hands. Why? Because it may give you the shock. Now, we have learned that in earlier that the materials which allow electricity to pass through them are good conductors of electricity. Yes or no? Which will allow the electricity to pass in them is known as good conductor of electricity. We come across so many substances, but some conduct electricity and some do not. For example, you can see here, that is the rubber, glass and wood. Will they allow electricity to pass through them? No, they will not allow. Yes or no? Then what happens here? What we say for them? For them we say it is poor conductor of electricity. It will not, that is, it is a bad conductor, you were learning. Now you should say it is poor conductor of electricity. The next year few substances are there. You can see aluminium foil, distilled water and copper wire. In this, which are the good conductor and which are bad conductor? Aluminium foil is a good conductor. Distilled water is a poor conductor or bad conductor of electricity. Water is a good conductor. Distilled water is a poor conductor of electricity. Copper wire, again a good conductor of electricity. Here you can see few electrical appliances which we use at home. Yes or no? These are the electrical appliances which works with the electricity itself. Without electricity, these are waste. What are good conductors now? The substance that allow current to pass through them are called good conductors of electricity. Example, all metals, etc. There, copper wires, aluminium foil are good conductors of electricity. Which are poor conductors now? Which do not allow current to pass through them. Which do not allow current to pass through them are called poor conductor of electricity. Example, wood, glass. Then how one can test that the given substance is a good or poor conductor of electricity? Okay, how do we know that whether it is a good conductor or a poor conductor? By using a tester. You have already seen here in the picture, you can see this is a tester. Okay, this one is a tester. It is an instrument that can test that the given substance is conducting or and not non-conducting. As you can see here, so any substance you can attach here like this to the free end of the tester. And a battery here. If it glows, the tester has a bulb. Okay. If the tester bulb glows, means the electricity, this is a good conductor of electricity. If it is not, the bulb is not glowing, then it is a poor conductor of electricity. We found that metals such as copper and aluminium conduct electricity, whereas materials such as rubber, plastic and wood do not conduct electricity. However, so far we have used our tester to test materials which were in solid state. So in the solid state we can use the tester. But what about in the liquid state? Can we use the tester? No. Do liquid conduct electricity? But how do we know that the liquid conduct electricity? To test whether the liquid allow electricity current to pass through them, it or not, we can use the same tester. However, replace the cell by a battery. Also, before using the tester, we should check whether it is working or not. Now you can see here, the same tester also can be used. Okay, now what you have to do is join the free ends of the tester together for a moment. Okay, this completes the circuit. Circuit is this, in the sense here you can see this is the complete circuit. It should not be open anywhere. However, if the bulb glow does not glow, it means that the tester is not working. Can you think of the possible reason? Means it is not working. It does not glow. It has been fault in your tester. So you should take the other tester. Or your cells are used up. You have to change the cells in the tester. Check that all the connections are tight. If they are, then replace the bulb with another bulb. Now test if the tester is working or not. If it is still not working, then replace the cells with fresh cells. Means the use of the tester we are saying here. Now that our tester is working, let us use it to test the various liquids. Okay, different kinds of liquids we are going to check now. While checking your tester, do not use its free ends for more than a few seconds. Otherwise, the cells of the battery will drain very quickly. Means you have to use only for the few seconds. Again, remove and keep. If the circuit is complete, the cell will dry up very fast. It will drain. Means the battery will go down. So now, collect a few small plastic or rubber caps of discarded bottles and clean them. Pour 1 teaspoon of lemon juice or vinegar in one cap. Bring your tester over this cap and let the ends of the tester dip into the lemon juice or vinegar. Take care that the ends are not more than 1 centimeter apart, but at the same time do not touch each other. Does the bulb of the tester glow? Does lemon juice or vinegar conduct electricity? Here you can see in the picture here how it is being kept. For example, this is our cap. In that we are taking different substances. First we will take the lemon juice in this. And here this is the connection of the wire. Okay. This is the cap. In that we have taken what? Lemon juice. Then from here it is being connected. Here this is our battery, that is bulb. And this is the battery. If it glows, then the current is passing. If it is not glowing, then this liquid is not a good conductor of electricity. It is a bad. Here you can see, we have not joined. What is joining here? The liquid. Okay. What happens here? The liquid, if the current is passing through the liquid, then it is a good conductor of electricity. If it is not passing, then it is a poor conductor of electricity. You can check with the different types of liquids such as lemon juice, vinegar or milk. Whatever you have, you can water, you can check. But you should be very careful when you are checking. When the liquids between the two ends of the tester allows the electric current to pass, the circuit of the tester becomes complete. The current flows in the circuit and the bulb glows. When the liquid does not allow the electric current to pass, the circuit of the tester is not complete and the bulb does not glow. Means if the bulb is glowing, then the electricity is passing through the liquid. If it is not glowing, then this is not a good conductor of electricity. It is a poor conductor of electricity. In some situation, even though the liquid is conducting, the bulb may not glow. Now, for example, we know that water is a good conductor, but still the bulb is not glowing. That means the water is a bad, poor conductor? No. Water is good conductor, but in your circuit something wrong, it is there. Okay, the bulb may not glow, it may happen. Now, for example, do you remember why the bulb glows when the electric current passes through it? Due to the heating effect of the current. Yes or no? Due to the heating effect of the current, the bulb will glow. The bulb has a filament inside. Yes, the filament of the bulb gets heated to a high temperature and it starts glowing. However, if the current through a circuit is too weak, now if your current passing is weak, okay, less, the filament does not get heated. It will not get heated and it will not glow. Sufficiently, it will not be passing. And it does not glow. And why is the current in the circuit weak? Now why it will be weak? Because though a material may conduct electricity, it may not conduct it as easily as a metal. Okay. This liquid may conduct the electricity, but it is not fast or enough like metal. Other metals will move. So it will become weak. As a result, the circuit of the tester may be complete, and yet the current through it may be too weak to make the bulb glow.